time for the moment of truth, I guess. Now we have an extension cord that we need to drag. Well, actually, don't need to drag it over that far. Just need to drag it to here. And we'll just plug our baby in. Alright, this is going to be the first fire up after the teardown cycle. Ready? We have the entire system up, so let's put something down on the turntable. Now we can fire it up. We'll put our George Strait where we last left off. And, but the last thing that we're probably going to need to do, we're going to have to realign this. So what we're going to do, we're going to have to get some Allen wrenches, loosen that up, and get it replaced back into where it's supposed to be. So. So now we have everything back to where it's supposed to. And now the funnel is not right. So, I think I got the wires backwards. So, what I'm going to have to do, we're going to have to take that wet groundwater back off again. I'll leave it off for now. Take this out. Switch it around. Hey, there we go, now we got sound now.
I couldn't care less if she didn't care anymore.
Alright, we're gonna shut that back off. We gotta put one water back on the switch. Alright. See what she does. Whoa! That turned out didn't right, did it? Let's see. Alright, dead people. Looks like we got a little bit of an issue here. Sure, our gripper arm must have really moved freaking fast on this one. But, why it doesn't help that our motor right here is actually quite loose on this thing. Let's see here. Oh yeah, that's that one thing I forgot. Alright then, we'll see what we can do to fix that. Alright, we're gonna have to get this back into our play position. Yes, we're gonna have to fix that little piece that we fixed. Now there's a piece, there's a thing inside that we need to adjust. So, let's just slowly creep this back. So what we're going to have to do, we're going to have to file this thing.
Alright, this is going to be a cheap cell phone video. Because I don't got my camera with me, because I'm actually working on the Rockwell just a little bit, because I wanted to try to do something. I wanted to figure a way on how to get this thing apart, so I decided to look at the manual and see what I needed to do. So, what I'm going to try to do, I'm going to try to get this thing apart, so that way I can get this properly brazed back together, so I can actually get it working again. It's going to be a royal pain to get this back on. I sure the heck don't want to replace it, let alone try to remill it. So, there's the first gear. It drives the gripper, that runs this gripper, the latching spring. So, but, now I'm gonna try to do something here. I want to try to see if I can get this thing apart, which is not gonna be easy. Not easy at all. So I will see if what I can do to try to get this thing out. Okay, I got the second gear off. This first gear right here runs the this part. It's held down by a screw, and it actually holds this guy. It's kind of dark, but you can kind of see him. He runs the change from the 33 RPM that operates on these, so which he bumps up against that this post. So this one right here runs the gripper arm back and forth. You can see the gripper arm is now pretty much almost in free motion right now. So I can pretty much move this thing back and forth anytime I want. So, but what I need to do, I need to somehow get this thing apart so that way I can get to the get this off next.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've finally done it. There's our problem child. He's out. What a relief. We gotta keep this guy right here so that way he doesn't go anywhere, so that'd be a bad thing. For what I can describe for the inside of this thing, it's a little nasty. No, but I don't think it's too bad at all. I can you could probably use a lot of freaking cleanup though. So, but it's like I said, it's not too bad though. Because I went by, according to what the manual says, that the piece that we're looking at, number 21, is attached by a pin number 25 to hold it in place against number 24, which is pushing on number 23 from number 22, which is the gripper arm assembly. So, and of course a lot of that runs through that right there, which has a hole. So that's number 10, number 12, number 13, which you see they're both right there, number 12 and 13. Number 13 is the one closest to me. That one right there, that was number 12. So, and of course the last part is this thing right here. So, well, we managed to get this thing apart. So that's cool. So, one thing I'll have to do, I'll have to clean this thing up and see if we can fix this. I surely don't want to remachine another one like this. Yes, it would be a royal freaking pain. I would think anyway. But if I have to, I'll see if I can, what I can do to remachine this. Probably what I'll do, I'll have somebody do a hog out for me. It'll be easier. Take this end right here, spin this on the lathe, and then do the rest of this. Because most of this is going to be mill work. So, okay then. So, that is another teardown of the Rockwella 443. Okay, I decided to take this thing out anyway, just to show everybody what it looks like. This is the other end of the grip. This is the one that grips on the records. It's got a brass center with a hole in the middle for the pin to go through. And that goes to that little piece that you've seen that I popped off. And that's the spring for it. That's a little springy. It doesn't have too much tension to it, so it's a pretty good spring. Just a little dirty, but I think it needs to be cleaned. So, I just wanted to show all of you that's what goes inside the gripper assembly to grab a hold of your records from the Rockwella.